my favorite courses to teach are genre courses, like musicals, romantic comedies, war films. Lately, I've been writing about and thinking about the social problem film. You've seen these movies. These are movies like Milk, or Hotel Rwanda, or To Kill a Mockingbird, or North Country, which is behind me on the screen. What's so interesting about social problem films is that they're caught between two opposing doctrines. The first is the doctrine of entertainment. And that's the idea that movies are just for fun, just for escapism. And that's what lies behind your friend saying, "No, I don't want to go see that serious drama. I want to go see a horror film tonight. I want to go see a comedy tonight." The opposing doctrine is that film, like all other arts, has a social responsibility. So what's a filmmaker to do? Well, Daryl Zanuck, who is the head of 20th Century Fox, and who is very key in promoting social problem films, had a solution, and that was to make social problem films entertaining. He once addressed a conference of screenwriters, and he said, I want to be accurate, he said, "If you have something worthwhile to say, dress it in the glittering robes of entertainment." Unless a film is enjoyable, Zanuck was sure that no propaganda film is worth a dime. Some detractors have felt that the films lose any integrity, and they get watered down and too commercial. In point of fact, though, there's some films that we can look to and see that they had an effect on audience beliefs and even on legislation. After I'm a Fugitive from a Chain Gang came out in 1932, the laws governing prisoners in Louisiana were changed. 2004 actually is a pivotal year in the history of social problem films. That's because that was the year a new production company was founded with a new philosophy. Participant Productions is not about making money. Their mission statement was changing the world one story at a time. Now you've seen their films. I'm sure you've seen their films. These are movies like Good Night and Good Luck, Murder Ball, Syriana, Darfur Now, oh, and North Country, and the biggest of them all, that cultural blockbuster of all time, An Inconvenient Truth. What Participant has done is that they link each film to an internet campaign, which asks the film goer to get involved with that specific social problem. And they've had really pretty good results in getting people to sign up, send emails, donate money, write letter to congressmen, and things like that. So now is a very interesting time in the history of the social problem film, and it will be interesting to see if Participant is successful in turning passive spectators into grassroots activists.